resale, don't do iCloud, don't do email. Feds wanna cop up, man, and wild, man, like Chubbs did details. Back when Ricky was doing up keys there, I was doing dinner with Easy.
Yo, gonna do a little voiceover telling you guys about how the meet went. So this was definitely one of the more exciting meets I've ever coached. Even though we were there from 9 a.m. to 8:30 p.m. And it was super crowded, by the way. One of the most crowded meets I've ever been to also. Probably like 500 people. It felt like there was like 500 people there. The warm-up area was super crowded. Despite all of that, it was amazing. And we had such a great training block. Me and Jolver have only been working together for a few months, but after a month of working together, we already started hitting amazing PRs. So we knew that this state record was possible. And the previous record holder, it was about 396 pounds. And all we needed to do was get 402, just like 5-6 pounds extra to get it. And everything was going really well. So we decided to just go for 402, even though you'll see him. When he performs this, it looks like he could have done a lot more. But it was a good call because you'll see right now when he takes his air into his stomach, you'll see the bar bounce up and down a little bit. And when you are attempting a state record, the judges are going to be very, very strict. They have national judges there who are not going to give it to you easy. Everything has to be perfect. And they want to see a fluid motion up and down. And even though they gave him one red light, all we needed was two for it to count. After he performs the lift, they have to check all of his gear just to make sure it's competition legal, and obviously it is. But yeah, man, just for this kid to be under so much pressure, just everybody there watching him attempting a state record, all of his family, all of his friends were there, a lot of our team members were there watching, and for him to just go up there, execute it so confidently and calmly, wow, like you don't see that in many people, let alone an 18-year-old. So we had a lot of momentum going into the bench press. And it was interesting with bench press because during the training for this meet, he was experiencing elbow problems, so he had to wear elbow sleeves. And we weren't 100% sure of how he was going to perform on this, but just hitting this opener alone would have been a meet PR. So we were already really happy, and we were just like, yo, if we end up hitting these second or third attempts, awesome. If not, whatever, we got the state record. And we already hit that bench press PR. And you'll see him holding like his temples right there because he took one of the strongest nose torques I've ever witnessed in my life. It was like a little blue bottle. I was standing about 5 feet away from him and I felt it. So it's really cool. It was really effective because you'll see that this moved really well. That last one, that last first attempt, it looked like it was like an RP9. It looked like it was probably his max, but he still ended up hitting this. And you'll see him give him one red light because the judges want to see one fluid motion up. If it stops or if it goes down, it doesn't count. And they're very strict at powerlifting meets. And I like that. I feel like they're starting to get more strict as the years go on. But I like that. I like to see that everybody is on an equal playing field. And when you go there, I just want to see some very good lifts with good form executed. And yeah, he still ended up hitting that. Amazing. We were 6 for 6 going into the deadlifts with a lot of momentum. Shout out to the owner of Threshold Headquarters on Ontario Hills. He gave us 2 free shirts after I bought a pre-workout gift for Jolver. It's kind of a tradition of mine to always buy my clients something when they compete. This is just a really amazing happy day for them, and I just want to always kind of go that extra mile to just see them even more happy because that makes me feel good. And yeah, at this point, I think we were just really tired. We had been there all day. This was like 7 p.m. And we only ended up hitting our first attempt of deadlifts, which is like 463 pounds. We missed our second and third. But either way, we left with that state record. We got the first place. Jolver left with that gold medal. He's going to be getting a certificate soon. And one of the best days of my life, Jolver. Thank you again for trusting in me. And I'm super proud of you, man. Now we're on to bigger and better things. We're going to chase that world record, and you guys will see us soon. So this isn't the last time you see me and him on the big stage. And thank you all for watching, and I'll talk to you soon.